As we do, let's start by settling the body in a comfortable, upright position, serviceable for meditation. So we keep our feet flat. We mainly think about maybe moving slightly off the backrest and keeping our spine straight, torso open, hands in the lap, either right over left, the palms upturned and the thumbs gently touching or resting on the knees. Moving our awareness throughout the physical body, noting any places of tension or discomfort, letting the body relax and settle. Finding a way for the body to kind of fall into place, fall into position. And setting an intention to just monitor mainly how upright the body is, to avoid slouching or leaning. Then we start to gather our awareness into the present moment. Allowing ourselves to have this time for meditation and not for distraction. So all of the things that would like our attention, we recognize that it's just another time for that. But when those thoughts or feelings arise, we can just gently let them go. Coming back to them later when we're finished. Using the physical sensation of the breath as it moves into and back out of the tip of the nostril as an anchor for our awareness. Again and again, letting go of anything other than that sensation. If it arises in the mind, again and again, gently bringing our awareness back to the breath. And with a more clear mind, we'll set our motivation. So again, we'll be looking at the factors, different factors that are implicated in the arising of disturbing mental states. So when we think of our motivation, we again can think that the main purpose of my spiritual life is to understand and overcome the states of mind that deprive me of happiness and contentment, and motivate me sometimes to act in ways that harm others. That's the main focus. So I benefit, but also all other sentient beings benefit. So we set a motivation, including countless others. So the next condition that we will contemplate is our relationship to sources of stimulus and media outside of ourselves. The things that we read, watch, listen to, the messages that those sources can carry. So think back over the past week or month, and think of how much time was spent being exposed to media sources. Listening to the radio, TV, surfing the internet. Think of how much time in an average day or week we spend consuming of sources of media. And then investigate how much of that is done with some important motivation versus how much of that is an effort to find a distraction. Think about if you have trouble being alone with your own thoughts, your own feelings. Do you turn to these sources of media as a way of avoiding? Going inward and spending time looking at your mind. Just check through in your own experience and see if there are any examples that stand out to you that you might want to pay attention to, think about. Try to think about the extent to which your self-image is influenced by the media and whether there are aspects of that that might seem problematic. What values and ideals might we be exposed to in those sources? And how might they shape our opinions, our views? Just think about your relationship to media sources and investigate whether you feel like you should make some change based on your own observations, and then come up with a couple concrete steps that you feel like you might take. Be determined to implement whatever changes you think might be beneficial. Now we'll move on to thinking about our habit patterns. So we can start by trying to observe the emotions and thoughts that most often arise when we try to quiet the mind, meditate. Are there patterns in the kinds of distractions and thoughts that arise? Just try to go back over the past few weeks. Try to observe what is it that again and again keeps trying to get my attention? What do I have to struggle against to concentrate the mind? Then look over the last few months and years in a general way, trying to look for patterns in your habits, your tendencies. Do I find that again and again I struggle with similar things? Am I often short-tempered? Or do I struggle with generosity? Do I tend to hold grudges? Do I have a lot of clinging attachment to possessions? There are different habit energies that tend to predominate, so just try to investigate. Question in your own mind whether you feel like you've heard or know of antidotes to these tendencies that are problematic. And make a determination to seek out more information, more teachings on the antidotes that you think you have some confidence will be helpful, and then to apply those antidotes when those habit energies are present. Try to set a firm resolve and rest your mind in it, to seek out and apply effective strategies and antidotes. And then when you're ready, we'll come back together. And then we'll dedicate. So we'll again recollect our motivation and the effort that we put into understanding the cooperative conditions that can activate disturbing emotions. We think that that wasn't just for our own benefit, but out of our concern for causing suffering for others and our desire to be able to benefit others. So we cultivate an open-hearted mind that offers the fruit of that practice for the benefit of each and every sentient being. Vast as space. And if we have some idea of enlightenment, then we think, may that karma ripen as a cause for my enlightenment so that I can fully actualize my wish to benefit beings without mistake. And may I come under the joyful care of the enlightened beings from now until then. And may all my spiritual guides abide in lifetimes without limit and without obstacle. Thank you.